Universal Century 0079, January 3rd. The Principality of Zeon declares war on the Earth Federation. The Zeon fleet, led by Vice Admiral Dozel Zabi, crushes the EFSF's cruiser fleet, utterly wiping it out. A mobile suit assault force, led by Major General Cassilia Zabi, seizes control of the lunar city of Granada. She then goes on to capture Von Braun as well. On that exact same day, Zeon also declares war against and attacks Side 2, called Hate, which had steadfastly maintained an anti-Zeon stance.
Fire and brimstone has rained down from the heavens onto Side 2. Just deserts for anyone who would dare harbor opposition to the noble Spacenoid cause! They've received punishment they've brought down upon their own heads! That it was the Federation that poisoned the minds of the foolish leaders of Hate. They are the true enemy!
It's a slaughter.
My countrymen, you 150 million citizens of Zeon, our fight has only just begun. Let us continue to march onwards, together in perfect unison, and we will not cease until we have victory!
Commander Rumbarol, entering the bridge.
Ah, great, you're here. Precisely, that's why I called you here. Our brilliant Supreme Leader Girin came up with an ingenious plan. In one stroke, it will put an immediate end to this war, ensuring Zeon a decisive victory.
We are going to murder those citizens and drop a colony?
Shh! You may want to rephrase that. The way you're putting it, it makes it sound like we're doing something wrong. Before you say anything, take a look at this! Here! We'll attach external engines to the colony, take it out of orbit, send it into low Earth orbit, and drop it on Federation General HQ at Jabara! You get it now?
Heat-resistant coating application complete.
Uprising at docking bay largely eliminated.
Booster attachment proceeding smoothly.
Pumping in the double G gas. There's a wind speed of about 10 meters per second inside. The gas should distribute rather quickly. Elapsed pump time, 5 minutes.
It's nothing personal. We're just trying to put a swift end to the war. Besides, I doubt you'd want to see the surface of the Earth rushing toward you. It'd be too terrifying.
Universal Century 0079, January 10th. Island Ifish, Mother Banshee of Side 2, Hate, leaves its Lagrange point and enters into a free-fall trajectory towards Earth. Its estimated point of impact was the Guiana Highlands in South America, which harbors Jaburu, the Earth Federation's General HQ, beneath it. A fleet led by Vice Admiral Tiana, which had been en route to engage the Zeon forces, abruptly changes its mission objective. It attempts to destroy the colony, but is unsuccessful. January 15th. Island Ifish enters into low Earth orbit. January 16th, the Banshee splits into three chunks, and each enters the Earth's atmosphere. Island Ifish makes impact with Earth. It causes massive destruction. The bay section strikes southern Australia, eradicating it. And the enormous land section that strikes southwestern Canada causes debris to rain down across the majority of America. The section that came down in the Pacific triggers massive earthquakes and tsunamis in densely populated East Asia. The Earth's crust and atmosphere are completely ravaged. The fatalities from this terrible calamity are so vast that its extent is not fully realized for some time. When the deaths from secondary causes such as disease and starvation are factored into the tally, it's clear that the final number of casualties is much greater than anyone could have imagined. It is roughly half of the world's population. However, this is not the end. The war has only just begun.